inside out, that the world will see you live in me. Shine from the inside out, that the world will see you live in me. You know me and you love me.
Hello everybody, welcome to my second kind of vlog. It's not a blog, it's a vlog, I've been told, of Holy Week, and I hope you're doing really well. Welcome to the Vicarage. By the way, I've not read all of these books behind me, by the way. You know, it looks like I'm really studious and I know what I'm doing, but I really don't. And you can see, as well as the books, a lot of my mess as well. I hope everyone is doing well at the moment. It still feels very strange to me this time. But I think one of the things perhaps that I'm kind of grateful for is, in a way, when you're stuck at home for most of the time, you kind of tend to notice things that you don't perhaps spend that much time noticing before. I spent a lot of time in the garden so far, and it's thankfully it's been wonderful weather. But I love that. I love spending time in the garden. I love seeing our trees. I love looking at, you know, just the small things, whether it's be the flowers that are out, or the grass, or the plants that we've got and stuff like that. And maybe there's just things around the house that you perhaps notice that you don't always notice when you're busy. I understand. I find it really disorienting at this moment, because usually my day is punctuated with me going outside and doing things and going to meet this person or going to that meeting, and it's not there anymore, and I feel quite sad about it. I imagine some of you will be feeling the same way. Maybe some of you might be quite used to spending a lot of time in the house, because that's just how we can. We're not that able anymore to go out very much. But I'm trying to appreciate the little things at the moment in all of this really hard time. And today I'll be looking at the passage from John, which is one of the readings in our lectionary today. It's John 12, 1 to 11. And it's that episode when Jesus is anointed by Mary. He goes to stay in the house of Lazarus again, and Mary and Martha. And Mary at this point kind of anoints Jesus' feet with this costly ointment, this nard that cost a huge amount of money. Throwing a lot of money at Jesus' feet. It's a really expensive thing. Think of something that, you know, is really expensive to us, really valuable to us, in that moment, just giving it all to Jesus. And I think people are shocked by this, you know, and Judas, who of course we know is kind of plays a big part in the Holy Week story, you know, Judas kind of complains and says, "Look, why is she doing this? This ointment costs money that could be given to the poor." But Jesus really appreciates what Mary has done, and Mary has acted in the moment. She's recognised, she knows who Jesus is. Maybe she's recognised the fact that Jesus isn't going to be there for much longer. And so she wants to honour him. She wants to worship him. And she does that. And I think the challenge for us is really just making the most of every hour, of every moment, every precious moment of each day, and just to give thanks to God for what he's done for us, and the fact that he is with us, and actually use this time. I know I feel very frustrated when, you know, and I'm sure you do as well, when people say, "Oh, you've got all this time on your hands now," but we are busy, we've got lots of things to do. But I mean, it's just great to take this opportunity just to spend some time, you know, thinking about the small things that we're just grateful for in our life. the small joys, the smiley faces, the small things, the wonderful nature that God has given us. I think we need to thank God for all that he has, you know, given us. And I know this is such an uncertain time for so many, and we'd be worried about our friends and our families at this time, that they remain safe. And I think I think we can despair that as well, and use this time to say, God, I don't understand what's happening with this world, but let's just take time in our daily lives just to give thanks to God and to notice the small things. And maybe that means just for a little moment putting aside the world problems or the stuff that we see in our news and all that kind of thing, and just focusing on the now and the present, and thinking about what God is trying to tell us at the moment. There's that beautiful psalm, and you might want to turn to it today, Psalm 27, which is in the morning prayer that we've given to the congregation. The prayer is from the Northumbria community, and there's some beautiful words in it that always kind of speak to me. I always feel like quite special to me, and it's just simply this. It says, "One thing I ask from the Lord, this only do I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord and to seek him in his temple. For in the day of trouble he will keep me safe in his dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of his sacred tent and set me high upon a rock. One thing I ask from the Lord, and this only do I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord." It's just those, well, I guess it's just remembering, you know, focusing our lives, remembering what God has done for us, remembering that we are just small, minute people on this beautiful, amazing world that God has created us and given us to help and support. And just acknowledging that our mission, our goal, our whole purpose is to dwell in the house of the Lord, to be with him, to recognize who he is and allow him to speak to us. And I'll be honest, I find praying and talking to God quite difficult. I should be better at praying given what I do for a living, but I find praying really tough. I find it really, really hard. I'd like to be a lot better than it. The truth is, I'm not very disciplined at all. I'm so disorganized. So I really struggle to find a time during the day when I'm just focusing on prayer and saying, this is what I'm doing. I find it really, really tough. I'm not great at it. And it's something on this holy week, this Monday of Holy Week, that I probably want to recognize the fact that, God, I'm no good at recognizing you. I'm no good at sometimes appreciating all the stuff that you've done for me and all the wonderful things you've done for me. I take you for granted. And Lord, I just want you to help me. Help me in all my kind of ways to just focus on you, because that's what I really want. I want to rest in you. I want to rest in the house of the Lord and appreciate the glory, the beauty of the Lord everywhere I go today. So I don't worry if you are you feel that you're a bad person at prayer or you finding it difficult. But maybe just use this time during this week to ask God for his love, his forgiveness, and say to God, I just want to spend some time with you today. By the way, you know, appreciating the small things, it's so amazing to see how communities are coming together through all this, and how wonderful it is to just see just acts of amazing kindness shown by neighbours, shown by people who didn't know each other very well a few weeks ago. I just sincerely pray and hope that this is the start of something. And I think it just goes to show how wonderful people can be when faced with these different situations. And maybe you've found that too, you know, with your neighbours or with your friends, and maybe people have done some shopping for you and things like that. And it's just truly amazing. And as I said, I'm so grateful for that. And there's lots of fantastic things going on in our community. Charities, organisations that are working really hard to help vulnerable people and people who are isolated, and just to big up a few of them, you know, organisations like Kids Cabin, absolutely fantastic, who opposite our church, they've been delivering activities to kids, and the Boster Youth Centre, Building Futures East. And all the schools, especially the schools, have been absolutely fantastic. So do pray for all the people involved in that. These people are not taking a break from their work. They're working really, really hard. Do pray for them and help them, Lord. And, you know, and I just, you know, pray that this good work continues and this community spirit continues. I think I've really been taught in an amazing way what loving your neighbour is really about.